look at this sea mouse. This is Tim Sheehan at Gulf of Maine, Tidepool Tim. I just had a fisherman bring in a bunch of these worms, marine worms, called sea mice. And you can see how they get their name. You look at the two tubs I have of them here. I mean, these are a polychaete worm, similar to like a sandworm or a lugworm, segmented worm. And these guys hang out in the soft sand and silty mud. Fishermen bring them to me. I have various accounts and customers looking for these. But sea mouse, the genus, the scientific name is Aphrodita, which of course is the goddess of love. But what's neat about them is they have these bristles down the sides. On the top, they have sort of a felt color, and underneath this felt is actual scales. I don't know if you can see this, but they're related to a scale worm. And we have, I mean, the average size that we see here, probably 3 inches, 4 inches in size. And you can watch this guy. He slowly stretches out. But they have little feet-like structures on the sides of them. These are called parapodia. And each one of the parapodia have these little bristles, these little setae on them. And the sun isn't out today. I'm at my shop. But in the sunlight, these have sort of an iridescent color. And they can be yellow, blue, green. Watch those little setae and parapodia move. There, on this one, you can actually see the scales. See the scales on the top of the animal? But these guys are interesting. They're actually quite a carnivore. They live in the mud on the bottom, and they're not only cannibalistic, but they eat every other kind of worm that they can find in the mud, from shimmy worms to lug worms, trumpet worms, scale worms, flood worms. This is like the ultimate horror for an annelid worm when you see one of these guys coming. And I'll tell you, you see that mouth right there? Now this one is probably perished, but oh no, his mouth just closed up. Let's watch this one here. I'm trying to touch it. That is the end of the story for a sandworm or a bloodworm. They actually swallow them whole, kind of like an anaconda swallowing a young warthog or a monkey or something. See them moving? A pretty neat creature, segmented worm, and we use them for scientific specimens here at Gulf of Maine. It's too bad the sun isn't out. You can't really catch that iridescence. These guys can live up to 9,000-10,000 feet deep in the ocean, and they're often dredged up by scientists when they're doing bottom surveys of marine life. Well, anyway, y'all. Hope you learned a little bit about sea mice. Once again, genus Aphrodita. They're segmented worm. They have these little parapodia. They're just a neat, neat creature. This is Tidepool Tim. If you like the channel, subscribe. We'll have more videos coming soon. Have a great afternoon.